Ready to get real? Go to drphil.com for advice on relationships, parenting, finances, and more. Plus, weigh in on your favorite episodes, share your stories, and find support in the Dr. Phil community. When you sign up for the community, you will automatically be subscribed to the Dr. Phil Show newsletter. Log on to drphil.com today. Well, viewers have been watching this live as it's happening. Tina Cummins says, come on, people, they're both culpable. Mom got a nanny from Craigslist to work for free, and nanny took it and ran with it. Cobra Girl AZ said they were both looking to take advantage of each other. I don't advocate for either, but the nanny knew what she was doing. Richard Cruz on TV says, this is a big wake-up call for anyone looking to have a live-in nanny. You need to use a service to help protect yourself. I've always said, you guys have heard me say this from the first year I was on Oprah, which my God was 18 years ago. I said, you gotta be careful who you let in your life. You gotta be careful who you let in your life. You gotta be careful who you let in your life. We all have to be careful. And if you had known this woman had filed 37 lawsuits against people, dozens of them against her family, it might have had an impact on you.
Right.
If you had known things about her that you didn't know, I don't know, maybe you'd have taken the job anyway, maybe you wouldn't have. But I can tell you this, running to the courthouse every time you have a dispute can shock you, because you never know what those people are gonna do either. Guys, we've got to stop. I thank everybody for being here today. More information on drphil.com. Thanks so much. Thank you. Good to meet y'all. Thanks so much. Bob, good to meet you.
Fill the whole family up with a large Papa Murphy's 5-Meat Stuffed Pizza. Our double-layered 4-pounder is now only $12. A large 5-Meat Stuffed, just $12. Papa Murphy's. Love at 425 degrees.
Amazing. Organize your garage with affordable solutions from Amazing Space. We install cabinets, workbenches, and organizers in amazing colors and styles. Available only at Amazing Space. Visit our showroom, 38th and Carolyn, Sioux Falls. Make your garage the envy of the neighborhood with Max Flooring. We install garage floors in one day with a 20-year warranty. No more oil stains or slippery floors.
Everything has its place with Amazing Space.
Visit our showroom, 38th and Carolyn, Sioux Falls.
Hello, Keloland. Meteorologist Grant Smith here in the Storm Center for your evening and overnight. We're looking at cooling on down to temperatures either side of 30 degrees, and also clear skies continue. We had lots of clear skies this afternoon. Those are going to continue into the overnight. The breezy winds will calm down to 5 to 10 miles per hour, and then we'll warm right back up to the 60s for eastern Keloland, central and western South Dakota, getting back up into the 70s, and we're looking at breaking some record highs on Sunday.
Mike Tyson in tears.
And you said that you were bullied.
When I went there, everybody made fun of me.
Next ET.
Tonight at 6:30 on Keloland TV.
Women in Business 2015, April 28th, featuring an engaging and entertaining message from Melissa Gilbert. Tickets and information online at Keloland.com.
Designate to you the wisdom of Solomon and the strength of Atlas. You are Captain 11.
Live from the Shrine Mosque, Captain 11 reporting, how's my crew today? Oh, we filled up the mosque at 1:30, half an hour before the show started. Everybody wave the right hand if you're here. If you're here, wave your right hand. All right, nice to see you. We're covering this with three cameras and two mobile cameras. We're going to try and get a lot of faces on there. Now, please don't wave again until we tell you. We have a lot of out-of-town visitors for this final show. And, you know, considering the winter road conditions, I'm so proud that so many of you came in to see me. I want to check a few out-of-towns. Let me step off the stage here and get a chance. If you're from out-of-town, raise your hand and tell me where you're from. All right, quickly, where are you from?
Hartford. Sibley, Iowa. Hartford. Colorado.
Did you say Colorado? You're from Colorado? Stand up. You have a Captain 11 t-shirt on and you're from Colorado. Your name is Derek, isn't it? Give me five right there. All right, pal. Thank you.
What's your name? Where are you from?
Baltic.
And?
Baltic.
A lot from Baltic right in here. Any other towns represented? Where are you from, sir?
Watertown.
Watertown. Lake Compesca. Where are you from, darling?
Madison.
Okay, where are you from?
South Dakota.
From where?
South Dakota.
From South Dakota. Where are you from?
Oh,
you live in Sioux Falls. He adopted me. Watch him. I bet he's not 6 feet away from me also. Where are you from?
Platte, South Dakota.
All right. How about over here? Where are you from?
Tucson, Arizona.
Oh, what?
Tucson, Arizona.
Stand up. In the middle of sub-zero weather, here's a girl from Tucson, Arizona. This is a snowbird in reverse. Was it too hot for you down in Tucson?
Yeah.
You come up see Grandma and Grandpa for the Christmas holidays?
Yeah.
Did you find the cookie jar?
No.
Grandma, listen, it's a law. All grandmas have to have cookie jars. That is a law. So you better get a chance to find it. Let's check some more towns, should we? Here we go. I'm going to come out here, over here. Where are you from?
Sherman.
Where are you from?
Winter.
Where are you from?
Boise, Idaho.
Uh-huh.
Renner. Boise, Idaho. Coleman.
Where are you from?
Del Rapids.
Okay.
What's up?
All right.
Marion.
And where are you from?
South Dakota.
Another from South Dakota. Wow. Let me get a chance to step back here. Bing, bing. Where are you from, sir?
Reno.
And?
South Dakota.
Here we are.
Texas.
Oh, my goodness.
Parker, South Dakota.
Oh, yes.
South Dakota.
Well, I'm so glad you all came here for my going away party. My goodness, it's nice to have all of you. Speaking of going away party, we got started in 41 years and 10 months ago. If I were to stick around until March the 7th, it would be my 42nd anniversary. Over that period of time, we've been through three generations. And I was just checking back here in the infant section, and I'd like to go back there right now if I can advise all my cameramen and my directors. I'm coming back, guys. I want to see some of those three generations showing up here for my final show. All of you sit still, please. Stay where you are. Sit down and let me find the three generations. Where are we? I have several right back here. Yes. All right, here we have
Jan Dorman
and
Chris Jones.
Where's our third one?
They're over here. They're over here.
Melissa, okay.
Haley, come here.
Get over here, guys.
Come here, Haley.
Come on, Haley. Get over here.
Melissa, too.
Melissa. They're not coming over. Come on, darling.
Here's one.
Three generations. All right.
Yes.
Nice having you with us. Thank you.
Thanks.
Are you having a good time?
Key.
Oh, I got that. More three generations. Thank you so much. What a nice compliment to have everybody come down together. Here we go, three generations. We're going to play Cinderella right here.
Thank you.
Yes. And?
Yes. Jacqueline Gunnarsson, Sioux Falls. I brought my children down when they were little.
Okay.
Lynn Gunnarsson Dahlstrom, enjoyed your show.
Thank you. Who's that?
This is Alexandria, my daughter.
Hi, Alexandria. How are you? I won't be around for your birthday, Alexandria, but I'm sure glad you're around for my going away party.
She's glad.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, sweetheart. Are you going to get a picture right here? Well, you should be in the picture, too. Wait a minute. One of my cameramen will do it. Somebody will take a picture of us. Who's going to take a picture with us? Come on. Do it today. There you go.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, here we go. That's it. All right, one of those double flashes. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. We're going to have so much fun. Gang, we'll be right back. I want to ask one more time. How's my crew today? Oh, yeah.
Your name?
Dana.
How old are you?
Five.
This is Christmas of 1957, isn't it? You gonna dance? You gonna dance? Okay, dance.
No!
Oh, you're not gonna dance. You're gonna sit and look pretty. Is that a pretty dress you got on? Why don't you turn around and show the folks how pretty that dress is, huh?
See him go? Now, those bubbles are available in what we call the bubbaloon game. And it's available at Toyland.
A Canton resident received the Distinguished Flying Cross for his efforts in the Vietnam War. More than 44 years later, he received the same award. Find out why coming up tonight on Kelloland News.
A run of warmer than normal weather will continue right through the upcoming weekend. We will slide back a bit next week. We'll have all those details coming up at 5.
Hi, crew. Pat O'Brien here, sitting in New York City, a long way from Kelloland. You know, there's so much to say about my friend Dave Dedrick, but I'll begin with a thank you, because Dave actually gave me my start as a wide-eyed four-year-old. I made my first television appearance on the Captain 11 show, watching along with all of you, all those lights and switches that always took us to a friendly place, Cartoonland. Little did I know that I'd end up trying to be just like Dave, and little did Dave know that he'd work this long, setting a longevity record unmatched in the television business. I get tired even thinking about it. Now, not too long ago, I was in an airport, and a guy came up to me and started reciting a familiar refrain. And at the end, he said, "And also, I have the wisdom of Solomon and the strength of Atlas." And then he turned and said, "Who am I?" I said, "Well, you're Captain 11." But I was wrong. There's only one Captain 11 and only one Dave Dedrick. And Dave, with your retirement, another historical chip has been chopped off the South Dakota landscape. So for CBS President Peter Lund, another KELO alum, and all of us here at CBS, we say thank you for the memories, the cartoons, and for making our lives a whole lot more fun. And I've always wanted to say this. So long, crew. Good luck, Dave.
Pat O'Brien. Thank you, Patrick. We have so many bases to touch on this final show, and the time is fleeting. A long time ago in 1955, when I went on the air, I was on all alone with the time converter for a few days, and then we got a couple of paper boys and a dog, and then we got a couple of three other crew members, and we took a picture. And 20 years later, I said, we put this picture on the air, and I said, whatever happened to these kids, my first crew that we got a picture of? An answer came down from Wentworth, South Dakota. The young lady's name was?
Donna Walt.
Donna Walt. And Donna was with me every one of my major milestones. Since then, Donna came down and brought her daughter down to the Captain 11 show. And then, this past summer, what happened?
My granddaughter came along, and you met her mom. And we now have a new grandson in our family as well.
There's another three-generation story. This is my first crew member. Thank you. Thank you, love. While we're talking about crew members, I have an idea in mind. We have so many babies over there. I just put out the call. Can I drift over there? Can you help me? I'm going to take a shortcut right through here. Watch it. Watch it. The big fellow's stepping right over you. Just watch your fingers. Okay. Oh, boy, you got a Captain 11 t-shirt. We don't even have any more of those. We're out of t-shirts, and we're out of frisbees, and we're out of everything. You got them. All right, you guys, if you hold the babies up, we want to get some shots of them, because I won't be around for their next birthday, and let's get a nice shot. So when they're 35 years old, you can dig this tape out and show them one more time how they look, like you. Boy, are you ready. How you doing? Are you having a good time? Oh, yeah. How you doing? Who is it?
This is Megan.
Okay, Megan. And you're having lunch back there. Good spot, right? I'm not gonna, you know, interrupt your lunch. You go ahead and enjoy. Now, we've got all the babies. We've got all the shots of them. Yeah, we will. Hold them up, please, so we can see. Where's the five-week-old? Right here? Oh. Come on up here. Come on up here. Listen, I'll make you a deal. We're going to stand right up here. 5 weeks old. Here, you hold it. May I borrow the baby?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Here, you hold this.
Hi, Mary.
Caitlin.
Caitlin, you're so excited about this, aren't you?
She's from Helena, Montana.
Caitlin's from Helena, Montana. Oh, Caitlin, you drove a long way for this show. Thank you, Caitlin. After a long trip like that, I can see where you're tired. And your name is?
Mary.
Mary, were you on the program when you were growing up?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing Caitlin with us. 5 weeks old from Helena, Montana. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now I'm going over to that side of the room. So let me walk through here, whistle my way through here. We have one end of the spectrum at 5 weeks old. And you know, one of the highlights of my program has always been, it's a birthday special kind of a thing. Suppose I could scooch through. I'm doing pretty well here. You guys are wonderful. Don't wake up. Okay. 5 weeks old, and then we get to birthdays, because extra special birthday time. And let me just check on, hello.
Hello, Dave.
What is your name?
May Shineman.
May? Whose birthday is it today?
It's your birthday.
Is it your birthday, May?
Huh?
Is it your birthday? And you've never been on Captain 11 before?
No, just watch you on TV.
Just watch me. Well, you're on today.
I know I am, and I...
You hate it.
No, I don't hate it, but Dave, I hate to see you go.
Oh.
Hey, yellow will never be the same.
Oh, you're such a sweetheart. How old are you? What birthday is this?
92.
92. Oh. Hey.
And Dave, could I personally thank you for your cookbook?
Oh, thank me for my cookbook.
I've got it.
Have you?
Everything in it, and I've given it to my granddaughter, so she's keeping it now.
Oh, that's wonderful.
It was.
Thank you. Well, listen, I'm going bye-bye, so do I get a bye-bye kiss? Right there.
Better give him a kiss.
Right, give me a kiss right there.
Give him a kiss.
Do I get a kiss, Kay?
He wants a kiss.
She doesn't know me well enough. Uh-huh.
But Dave.
What?
Whatever you do, I hope you're happy.
I will be. But I've been happy every day of my life.
But I hate to see you go. It's not.
Oh, listen, we got some of the greatest crew to carry it over.
Do you know who's going to be our new weatherman?
Yeah. Oh, happy birthday, Kay. Oh, gang, let's meet this people. What is your name?
Allison.
Okay, who's this?
It's Alex.
How you doing, pal? Give me five right here. Thank you. All right, back here. What's your name?
Leah.
What's your name?
Katie.
And your name, who's this?
Abby.
Abby?
Yeah.
Abby's having a fake lunch. Okay, I'll be over. Who's this?
This is Tisha.
Okay, we're coming around here so we can get some more pictures. We have an overflow crowd here since a half an hour before the show even started. Who is this?
This is Cole, and it's his first birthday.
Today's a birthday? Well, happy birthday. He's celebrating. Glad to see you. 1 year old. Oh, that's wonderful. Listen, I won't be around for your second birthday, but I'm sure glad I'm here for this one. Happy birthday to you. Yes, honey. Thank you.
I met you in Esteline when I was about 6 or 7, and I was never on your show until now.
Well, I'm glad you're on now. How many of you moms and dads grew up with Captain 11? Of course, the one, you know, there's one hand waving back there. It's Bobby Lauer. You know? Trent. Bart, what? Yes. Okay. We're going to be here now. We're finishing up the second segment. We have an overflow crowd in our studio. I'm going to put all of you guys talk to each other. I'm going to tiptoe across the street with our cameras, meet with them for about 7 or 8 minutes, and I'll be back. So how's my crew today? I love it. Live from the mosque.
People in your head sing birthday to you, didn't they? Well, you having a nice time today?
I just have one little bone to pick. I never got to be on the show until I was Miss South Dakota. I never got to be on as a kid. But boy, I sure did watch. We all did.
I was not only a fan, I was a diehard Captain 11 believer. I wanted to be like Captain 11 when I grew up. That never happened, unfortunately. But Dave Dedrick and Captain 11 are used interchangeably. I think there are thousands and thousands of people who use Captain 11 as their role model for good reason. He was a role model, and there are a lot of people that will never forget the contribution they made to our childhood.
Above and beyond the 950 that we have in the mosque, we had the overflow crowd brought into our Keller studios, which makes actually a bigger Captain 11 crew than I've had. My goodness, everybody wave. Wave your right hand if you're here. All right. I'm ready for this over here. How's my crew today? And I have a lot of out-of-towners here today. We're going to get the cameraman around to take your picture. Show me some out-of-town hands. If you're from out-of-town, tell me where you're from, quickly.
Harrisburg.
Uh-huh.
Harrisburg.
Okay, over here, out-of-town, where are you from?
Marion.
Okay, over here, where are we going? Let me step back here and meet with the show. Where are you from?
Biden.
Okay.
Brandon.
Uh-huh.
Brandon.
Okay.
Brookings.
Okay.
South Korea.
What?
South Korea.
South Korea? You came a long way from my going away party. I'm sure glad. What's your name?
Emily,
I'm sure glad you're here. Thank you for coming. Okay. And who else is from out of town? Anyone else from out of town? Where are you from?
Colton, South Dakota.
All right. What about this guy?
Colton, South Dakota.
Oh, I think so, Colton. How about over here?
Texas.
Uh-huh. And how about you?
Texas.
Texas? You guys say Texas? Yeah. My goodness. Snowbirds in reverse. You wait till it gets to a skating 8 below 0, and then you leave Texas and come up here. Stand up, you two guys. Two guys from Texas. Huh? Are you from Texas, too? The whole bunch of us. Stand up if you're from Texas. Well, she says, I'm from... Where are you from?
Texas.
Okay. Did you all come up to visit Grandma for the holidays?
Yes.
Did you? Did you find the cookie jar?
No.
Listen, it's the law. Grandmas must have cookie jars. That's the law. You found it?
Yes.
Oh, don't tell them. Don't tell them. All right, welcome from Texas. Thank you. So who else is from out of town? Back here. Let's step back here.
T.
All right.
Iowa.
Valley Springs.
Okay, whereabouts in Iowa?
Near Des Moines.
Okay, welcome. Thank you for coming. Where are you from?
South Dakota.
Oh, she's from South Dakota. Let's hear it for the girl from South Dakota. And we have Cinderella here. Cinderella, hello, Cinderella. And where are you from? And how old are you?
One.
One. And what happened to your shoes? Cinderella. Oh, she's having so much fun. Where are you from?
Iowa.
All right, stand up, girls. Two girls from Iowa. Now, this is extra special because I've been doing this for 41 years and more. These two young ladies are, where in Iowa? What town?
Des Moines.
All right. These two girls from Des Moines, Iowa, are now going to sing the Iowa corn song. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Get out of here. Am I the only one left in the world that knows the Iowa corn song? Yeah. All right. Step down. My goodness. How old's the baby?
3.5 months old.
3.5 months. I'm sure glad you're... I won't be around for your birthday, but have a good life.
Say thanks.
Okay. I found one that's, just a few days, something. Oh, let me get back here. See, where can I go around? Can I go around the end there? I think so. Okay. This is the kind of situation where directors and cameramen just go crazy trying to find a shot, so I want to give them a half a chance. Yeah, we're going to split the difference. Oh, look at this. How... Well, did you just meet Katie from across the street, having her 92nd birthday on the Captain 11 show? And how old is this?
She's 26 days. She was born
26 days. Here, hold this for me. Okay. Thank you. May I?
Yes, you may.
26 days. And what's your name?
Miranda.
Hi, Miranda. Miranda is opening her eyes. Miranda says, what is going on here? Miranda, this is your television debut. There you go, sweetheart. And see, Miranda, when you're 35 years old, Mom will be pulling that tape out to show it to you. What do we have here? An old Polaroid from a birthday party. 1955, May the 5th. Stand up. Are you this little one right here?
No, over here.
Oh, you haven't changed at all.
No.
And we used but to, then I haven't either.
No, and you used to live across the street from us.
Oh.
On Sunset Drive.
Yeah, Sunset Drive. Thank you for coming. All right, gang. Now, let's see. Let's see if we can meet some more. We got nice close shots on all of these guys. Did we get all of the out-of-towners? I missed this area down. Anyone here from out-of-town? What's your name?
His name is Ronald. He'll be two tomorrow.
Ronald, happy birthday. You're going to be two tomorrow.
He visited you on your first?
Oh, yes. On my last television show. Wonderful. Gee, it's a nice going-away party. I'm glad all of you are here. Now, listen, I think we're going to have some... Unless I'm mistaken, I think you guys over here really get a deal because I think we have cookies. Okay? All of you guys stand up. All of you seated on the floor, stand up. Stand up here now. Okay? Now look at the camera. Look at the camera right over there. I'm going to practice to see if this side's any good as the one is over at the mosque. Wave one hand. Now both hands. Now both hands and one foot. Now both hands and both feet. Now I'm going to count to three and we're going to play Freezeburg. When I count to three, you freeze solid. One, two, three, freeze. You're frozen. Now you can't move. Don't blink your eyes. Don't blink your eyes. Don't move. Don't giggle. You are frozen solid. Oh, it works. I'll meet you over at the mosque in a minute and a half. Thanks, guys.
Hey, business, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are you going to be when you grow up?
Well, I don't know yet.
Well, that's all right, because you just take your time. I'm not trying to rush you.
For us, of course, after school was to watch, Captain 11. Amen. So, just the memories. When I even found out about this interview, the first thing that came to my mind, no kidding, was the spinning wheels in the back, the time wheels in the back, and the sounds. And there was such, high tech back then. Just so much fun. We were getting into trouble every now and then, but maybe those times where we weren't in trouble was when we were watching Captain 11.
Well, like every kid who grew up in South Dakota, I came home from school and watched Captain 11. It was one of those things, I think, that all across South Dakota just became an institution. And Dave Dredrick and the important role that he played through all those years, I think, was very impactful on a lot of young people across South Dakota. When I was growing up in Myrtle, we got one TV station. That was Kelloland. And so we were able to, and I go down to my grandma. She had a black and white television after school, and we watch Captain 11. So those are some of my memories, and I know all across South Dakota, people growing up share those memories. And so I'm, like so many others on this particular anniversary, want to wish Captain 11 a happy anniversary. Well, when I was growing up in Myrtle, South Dakota, we got one television station, and that was Kelloland, and it was in black and white. And there were a few constants in life. There was Mom, there was apple pie, there was the flag, and there was Captain 11. And I can't imagine a generation of Americans growing up without him, and I know he's going to be missed. So it's on this, historic commemorative occasion, wish him well, but he's going to be missed.
Yes, Captain, the mop-haired kid on the right, that's me. Thanks for the inspiration, and thank you for making me believe I could be on TV.
Well, I guess you can't control time, huh? Captain, it's been great having you around. We're going to miss you. Thanks for the memories.
Goodbye, Captain, and I really do remember the advice you gave me when I first came to Kelloland. You told me to slow down when I say my name. You called me Miss Armstrong because I say Jessica Armstrong. I do keep it in mind sometimes. We'll miss you.
There's a line from the song, The Wind Beneath My Wings, which says, did you ever know that you're my hero? You've always been mine, Captain, and always will be.
We're live at the mosque here for the taping. How's my crew today? For this final show of Captain 11, I want to digress and go back to Once Upon a Time through the memory books. Come along with me now. In the 1950s, when I had the time converter, I first started turning on a switch for a little pal of mine who was sick. His name was Roger Anderson, and I turned that switch on for Roger every day. Pretty soon, the list started to grow a little bit and a little bit, and then I started turning switches on for...
Ellen, for Shelley.
And who's Shelley?
That's me.
That what?
I met you at McKinnon Hospital in 1958, and you used to turn on switches for Eleanor, Shelley, Billy, and Joey every day.
That's right, I did. You know what? I used to have a Jody in Nassau, Minnesota, that I turned switches on for. Jody had been scalped in a farm accident. And we had a fundraising thing and had all the kids selling lemonade and doing all kinds of chores and car washes and so forth to raise money for Jody. And as God is my witness, yesterday I opened the mail and there's a letter from Jody from Nassau, Minnesota. And she thanked me for everything all of the kids had done for me on Captain 11. And she was all grown up now and all well, had been through all of her surgeries and was perfect. So, Shelley, it's good to see you here. Thank you.
Good to see you. Good luck, Captain.
All right. Well, I get a kiss. Yes. Thank you, Shelley. I'm not about to pass this opportunity up. My children have all grown up knowing one thing, that the lions are loose. That always means that Daddy's not going to be there because Daddy's going to be out making an appearance someplace. I've been to 180 towns and cities across Keller Land, across Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, and South Dakota. But Saturdays seemed to be the day that they were celebrating someplace and having a parade someplace, and they wanted Captain 11 to come with them. So I would have to tell my kids, they would say, can we do something? And I would say, I'm sorry, kids, but the lions are loose. That's been a joke in our family ever since. But here, the one lady I want to introduce is Mrs. Captain 11. I think one of the first public appearances I made was at Farrington Super Value in Worthington. I was just stampeded. I couldn't believe what could happen to a grocery store. We just absolutely destroyed it with a volume of kids that we put through there. Then I went to Pierre, Governor Foss. I met Governor Foss on the stand of the Pierre Armory there, the auditorium, and he said, we had 5,000 kids there, and he said, don't you wish they could vote? Well, now I have three generations. Boy, that's an awesome thought. Yes, Bobby. Bobby Lowry.
Mel Cook wanted to bring you a newspaper, but he couldn't find one, so he just came by himself.
I told you, the first program I had, the first kid I ever had on the air, I looked outside the window and I was reading, you know, what do I want to be when I grow up? And I looked out this rainy, cold afternoon, see two little guys out there with a big black dog. It affected me so much, I remembered it for so long, that's part of my book. And I was, the other day, I just happened to, strangely, somebody said, I know who that kid was. And we called him up and it was
Mel Cook.
Mel, do you remember that?
Yes, I do.
Well, how long ago was that, Mel?
Well, they said in 55 you started, so we were out there outside your window looking in.
Sometime in the middle of March of 55, yeah. Looking through the cold rain and everything. Yeah. And he brought his big black dog and his, who was with you, your brother?
My brother, JB. He's up in Minneapolis now. But,
well, thank you for being on the last show.
Thank you.
Okay, Captain. Partner. Thank you, Mel. While we are talking, and I'm keeping your attention centered, my cameramen are sneaking around getting shots of all of you so that we can superimpose them. The way this works now will be televised not only Saturday from noon until 1, but repeated again from 4:30 to 5:30 on New Year's Day. My great thanks to the El Riot Shrine clowns. They are here. Look at this. They are here. Okay, listen. One of the things that we did when we went to the state fair, I found out that when I work with so many doctors, I did that when everybody was having casts. And I spent so much time at the Crippled Children's Hospital and school then. But I found out from the doctors that about age seven, your lungs start to develop their maximum elasticity. Under that, they're pretty fragile. Then they get up to about seven, they become a little more powerful, and a little more powerful, they have the ability to really handle the breathing for you. So I said, wait a minute. If I could have about 5 7-year-olds, who's 7 years old? I need 5 of you up here on the stage, please. If you're 7 years old, I want 5 of you on the stage. Just at the first 5. I'll take 5 of you on the stage if you're 7 years old. And we don't tell me. Okay. These 5 7-year-olds are... We got all 5 of them, Devin? I would be remiss right now, ladies and gentlemen. Probably the hardest working man I've ever met in my life for Captain 11. Without him, there would be no Captain 11. He has been my guardian angel over 15, I don't know how many years it's been. The promotion manager from Kello, Devin Duckett, right here. I've never given away a toy or a balloon or a frisbee that he hasn't ordered. He's followed me around. He's handled a crash course of... We have all 5 of them here? All 5 of these 7-year-olds here right now? Oh, this is going to be something. This is going to be a biggie. Now, you guys, listen for instructions now. We all have it. Get a balloon. Grab a balloon. You all have one? Did you get a balloon? Grab one. Get a balloon from him. Get a balloon. I'll show you what I mean, see, about this. Don't blow it up. Don't blow it up. No, no, no. No, no, no. Don't blow them up. You all have one? I'm going to step down here out of the way now, if you don't mind. Everybody keep your eyes focused on the stage and the 7-year-olds. Okay, gang. Now, the idea of this, I want... What? What?
I got my boots on.
Are you 7?
I got my... Yeah.
Oh, you got your blue boots on. Are you 7?
Yeah.
Are you 7?
Yeah.
Devin, give this 7-year-old a balloon here. I shouldn't have checked his ID, shouldn't I? I should have checked his driver's license. Are you all set, guys? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to count down from 10 to 0. When we get to 0, you start blowing that balloon up. You continue to blow it up until it bursts. All right? Now, just keep blowing up until it bursts. Are you ready? Everybody help me out. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Blow, blow, blow them up, blow them up. Come on. Are the lungs developing? Are the lungs developing? Watch. Are the lungs going? Look at them. They're getting bigger and bigger. Yes! You're looking good. You're doing great. You're doing great, honey. Come on, Derek, get that blowing up there. Yes, you're doing great. 7-year-old, look at this. You keep going. Keep going until it busts. Oh, you're... Keep going. Keep going. Don't talk to me. Concentrate on busting that balloon. Come on. Keep going. Keep going. Rarely can 6-year-olds do this, and 8-year-olds do it pretty quickly. So 7 is the perfect age bracket to work this. Come on. You're doing great. You're doing great. Whoa! Oh! 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 Are you 7? Step over here. Oh! Oh, my... Step down here. Oh, look at this. Excuse me just a minute. Smile at me. Oh, they're all still there. I'm so glad you did such a good... What is your name?
Ramon.
Where are you from?
South Dakota.
Remote from South Dakota. Can you get us any closer point than that? Like, just from South Dakota. Would there be an address or a zip code or anything? Any town?
Sioux Falls.
Oh, gotcha. From Sioux Falls. Okay, congratulations. I think we have a prize for you. Okay, gang. Now, we're going to be around one more time, so I want to stop and see all of you. You're welcome for that. I think we have some balloons for all of you, incidentally. We have 1,500 balloons to pass out this afternoon. So stick around with us one more time. How's my crew today? All right. Watch this. We'll be right back.
One man in each century is given the power to control time. The man chosen to receive this power is carefully selected. He must be kind. He must be fair. He must be brave. You have fulfilled these requirements. And we of the outer galaxies designate to you the wisdom of Solomon and the strength of Atlas.
I think Captain 11 is really part of the glue that binds several generations of South Dakotans together, because we all grew up with some of the same sorts of entertainment, but also important lessons that he taught on his show all those years.
I used to babysit for the captain. We were next door neighbors, and I think one of my fondest memories of Dave was the one time there was a promotional on the Captain 11 show, I think, with a bunny rabbit. And he brought that rabbit over and gave it to me at the end of the promotion, and we just loved it. I had six little brothers, and we thought that rabbit was just great.
The one memory I have of Captain 11 is my brother got the great big Tootsie Roll, but I have one up on him now. I got to work with Captain 11, and I think that's the best.
Captain, over the last 27 years, my family has run two kids through the time converter, and we appreciate that. They appreciate that. We all wish you the best in your retirement. But I have one question. In your capacity to control time, did you ever notice a freshness date on those big Tootsie Rolls?
We'll miss not having you around, Captain 11. We can always use the wisdom of Solomon when making a weather forecast.
Captain, goodbyes are never easy. My fondest memory I have of Captain 11 is when I was down at the Wally's Jack and Jill store in Parker. In walks the captain, gives my mom a big hug, and I'm saying to myself, that's right, that's the captain hugging my mom. Gonna miss you, bud. See ya.
The celebration continues. So how's my crew today? Great. It's the final taping of the Captain 11 show, and we're going to continue on our quest. We have a lot of three generations. Since the Captain 11 show went on March the 7th of 1955, I've had an ample opportunity to create three generations of fans. Where are we now with three generations? Right here. I think, who signaled out three generations? Where are we? All right, let's find out who they are.
I'm Alan.
Brian. That's Austin, and it's his first birthday today.
Well, happy birthday, Austin. I think we have a prize for you. Promise on us, Austin. Happy birthday. For you and all the rest of the guys. Well, how are you, sir? Hey, nice having you with us. Thank you so much for being with us and sharing your birthday. Okay, Austin, I won't be around for your second birthday, but I'm sure glad you're here. Okay. I want to make sure Austin gets a prize. Oh, who's this?
This is Garrett.
Hi, Derek. How are you doing?
He's going to be 5 months old on Monday.
Okay, good. Monday, incidentally, is the open house that they have for me at the downtown Holiday Inn. Yes, ma'am.
It's her fifth birthday today.
Today's your birthday? Stand up here. Let me see. Your fifth birthday, right? What's your name?
Julie.
A birthday's kind of special, isn't it? And your birthday's today. I have a present for you on stage. Okay? Would you come up and get it for me? Come on with me. Come on. Come on. Who else is having a birthday today? If you're having a birthday today, come on up and join me on stage if it is your birthday today. If today is your birthday, I want to see you on stage. Boy, we've built a whole career out of birthdays. Except Kate. Kate, I'll let you sit back there. I'll send a present back. Are you guys all having birthdays today? Okay. All right. Birthdays? Okay. You all having birthdays? Get up here. I think you guys are just missing the boat. What? We have birthdays?
Yes.
You want to step back there and pick out a birthday present? Okay, step back along the wall and pick out each one of you get a birthday present. Happy birthday. Is your birthday? Go get a birthday present. Is it your birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah. When is your birthday? June 10th. Close enough. Go get a present. Pick out a present from back there. Is it your birthday?
Mine was after Christmas, but...
Yours was after Christmas? It is after Christmas. Close enough. Get a present. Okay. What?
It's my birthday, too.
How old are you?
Six.
And it's your birthday now? Go get a present. Hold it, guys.
My dad's birthday's tomorrow.
What?
My dad's birthday's tomorrow.
Your dad's birthday is tomorrow. Go get a present for your dad. My dad's birthday. Did you get a present? Is it your birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah, he says over his shoulder while he heads for the loot.
She wants a present.
Okay, why not? If there are any left up there, you go get one, will you? Okay. You all get a present. Save one for my buddy over there. Save one for my buddy. You get a good one? You guys all have a happy birthday now?
Yeah.
I won't be around for your next birthday party, so keep that as a memento, will you? I love you. You bet you can. Okay. How about a nice hand for all the birthday guys here? And I confess we did not card any one of them. All right. Return to your seats, guys. Let's make ready for the next shift.
22nd.
What?
My birthday was the 22nd.
Close enough. If there's anything left up there, go get something. Let me get one of those little dolls for my little babe over here. Okay? Pick up one of these dolls. Get one of those dolls. Get him one. I want to save this for that little babe over there. Here we go. Yeah. Sure. What?
My birthday was in September 6th.
You're that close. Go get a present. Hold it, gang. Hold it. Hold it. The feeding frenzy begins. Oh, we've had so much fun over the years playing this game. Okay. That's it. All done. Presents all gone. Save that one for me. That didn't get away, did it? Okay. Yes. Here's a story. I want to hear from you, young lady. What is your name?
Rachel.
And?
Sarah.
And what happened?
Well, we're twins.
Yeah? And then what happened?
We were on your show in like either 71 or 72.
Well, that's about 25 years.
Yeah.
Well, you grew up very well. You still remember that. Where were you from?
We're from Sioux Falls.
Okay, and where are you from?
Sioux Falls.
Where were you born?
68.
Where were you born?
68.
They're twins! Gotcha. All right, thanks for coming back.
You bet.
All right, team, watch this message. We'll be right back. Right, gang? Okay.
Great show, and I know we watched it a lot when we got home from school, and actually had the opportunity to go on there a few times. I did get scolded on his show one time. I was on there with a friend, and we were messing around talking while Captain 11 was trying to do his program, and so he, right on the air, told us to knock it off, and which we didn't think was a big deal until we got home, and once I had to meet my mom, and she watched the show to see us, and then she saw what happened. So yeah, I got in a little trouble when I got home after that.
Oh, that was always the first thing we did was flip on and catch the Captain 11 show. And again, it was with my children, and I'm sure it was with many children after that. The role that he played as we were growing up, as our Sioux Falls version of a hero. That was very important.
The Northern State women's basketball team is playing at the Division II Central Region Tournament. We'll have the highlights coming up at 6.
Lots of sunshine, lots of warmth for the upcoming weekend. Our temperatures will continue to be 20 to 30 degrees above normal, though the winds will pick up, especially towards Sunday. Next week, well, we're going to slide back a bit temperature-wise. We'll have your St. Paddy's Day forecast and more at 5.
You're a local star that'll shine no matter where you go. Good luck, Captain 11.
Goodbye, Captain. We're going to miss you. I didn't have the opportunity to grow up with you, but my daughter Chloe did, and I know that we are both going to miss you terribly. Good luck.
I'm working on the strength of Atlas, but I don't think anyone will ever be able to take your place. Goodbye, Captain.
Captain, remember when my son used to dress up and act like he was you? He still thinks you're great, and so do the rest of us. Thanks for making all the kids, mine included, feel special.
So here we are on the home stretch here, the final show from Captain 11. Be aired today, and it'll also be aired New Year's Day from 4:30 to 5:30. Now, as we get to the closing segments of it, recalling some 41 years and 10 months. That's how close we were to closing out 42 years. I have a special gift that I want to take over here, if you guys let me scooch through there. Sorry, just hold still. If you're holding still, I can step around you. If you're scooching around, you may cat. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I'm falling in love. Hi, sweetheart.
Hi.
What's your name?
Kaylee.
Kaylee, how old are you?
4.
You're 4 years old. You came to see me today. I love you. Is that all right? Okay, would you take care of those for me? You think you could take care of those for me? Just a special gift just for you. And if you ever try and lose them, just look for all these balloons. Because they'll be right under all those balloons. Okay?
Thank you.
I love you. Could I have a kiss? Could I have a kiss? Mm-hmm. Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you. We're going to get a picture of this for you. Okay. Please, let's get a picture. You want a picture? All right. Here, we'll get somebody to take it for you, honest. Okay? We're all covered. All right, thank you. I'm going to scooch back this way now. We had so much fun. Trent Parks and Jill, right after my book came out, threw a special treat for me up in Madison. I had no idea what was going on, but they invited me to come up to Madison. When I arrived up there at the university, at the college, at the field house there, they had a special day, and that special day was about 6,000, 7,000 people, I don't know, gathering at the field house to say hello. And they are right here, and they've been strong, strong supporters of my Captain 11 show. Trent and Jill and Chase and Cameron. Right, pal? Yes, good to see you. Good to see you, pal. Thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
All right, gang. Now, I'll tell you what, we're getting down right close to the nitty-gritty here. And I would invite my family to please come up on stage. Come on, get up on stage. Boy, has this been fun. Let's meet the gang now, all of them. Here we have
Ian Dedrick.
Ann.
Travis Snyder.
Justin Snyder.
Eli Dedrick.
Sunshine.
Sunshine. Here's my doll. And here's my super doll. And as of everybody's asking, as we get ready to retire and head for the Outer Galaxies of the last year, everybody's asking what I intend to do. I'll tell you, what I intend to do is turn over my bookings to her. She is going to be my travel agent and my business manager. So I'm just going to drop off the face of the earth and follow her, and I'm going to carry the luggage. Margene. Right. And we have
Allison.
And
Karen.
And?
Dana.
Dana, my big number one son, right here, Dana. So there's my family. With all of that, I want to get all of you to stand up now. We're going to get tricky here. Over the years, I stumbled on this one time quite by accident. It has become the most memorable thing that has ever happened in the history of the Captain 11 show. Now, all you have to do is follow instructions. And the important thing is, when we play Freezeburg and you freeze, do not move for a minute and a half, okay? Guys, thank you so much for all of your acceptance and all of your love.
What if I have to sneeze?
All right, wave one hand. Both hands. Both hands and one foot. Now, both hands and both feet. One, two, three, freeze. Now freeze. Now you're statues. You can't move. Don't blink your eyes. Don't blink your eyes. Our cameramen are getting shots of you. You're just like steel. You're stone. Is this great? 950 people packed into the mosque, and I'm the only one that's moving. And I'm not moving very much. I am so deeply grateful to all of the production staff and the guys who put it all together. Watch as their names roll across the screen as I pay homage to them. Gang, so it's time to go, and I want to get you to play the game one more time so that we can wrap it up the way we always have. Wave one hand, both feet, and both hands and both feet. Now, guys, have a great life. Mind mom and dad, eat everything they tell you to eat, brush your teeth, and pray your prayers as you go to bed.
It's been said that each person may expect 15 minutes in the spotlight. I've enjoyed it for 42 years. My heart is full of appreciation and gratitude for the three generations of caring fans. There's a proverb that states, a man never stands so tall as when he stoops to help a child. If I were to leave a legacy, it would be that on some future day, each of you might sit down with a child and say, once upon a time, there was a man. Thank you. all. My cup runneth over.
So long, crew. Nice being with you.
For years, I wanted to go visit Captain 11, and finally, for I think it was my 9th or 10th birthday, had the chance to take a lot of friends down, and I will never forget getting to not only be there in the studio, but seeing Captain 11 in person. It was overwhelming, and we had a great day. So lots of wonderful memories, and I think almost every kid in South Dakota, that was their aspiration those days, was to go visit Captain 11 in person. We would wave one hand, wave two hands and jump on one foot and freeze. We did that every day watching the show. So when we got to do it in person, we could hardly stand it. So yes, a lot of fun memories and a wonderful heritage we have.
Live from Kelloland Television, Kelloland News at 5.
Good evening. Two people arrested during a drug bust at an in-home daycare made their first court appearance today.
Jennifer and Adam Darger are facing multiple drug possession charges for allegedly selling meth. Today in court, a prosecutor revealed that Jennifer's 16-year-old daughter told her that the Dargers were selling meth at the in-home daycare, which led to an investigation. Within hours of receiving the tip, authorities searched the home on West 53rd Street. Inside, they found 5.9 grams of meth packaged in 7 baggies. 5 young children were also inside the home, including 3 daycare children. The Department of Social Services reunited those kids with their parents.
Yeah, well, one of the biggest issues with this recent bust is that Jennifer Darger was licensed by the city and state, even though she has a criminal record. In 2006, she pleaded guilty to drug charges. Kelloland's Sammy Bielan shows us what the city and state require from daycare providers.
In February of last year, Jennifer Darger started her in-home daycare, Jen's Gems. Following city ordinance, she had a pre-opening inspection and a random inspection in May. She passed both.
From the time she started till now, she has had no citations or anything.
But that clean record doesn't go back terribly far. 8 years ago, Darger pleaded guilty to felony drug charges. That didn't stop her from being licensed to run an in-home daycare.
City and state ordinances only require us to check back 5 years. So if it was prior to that, we would have no record of it.
Well, the law delineates the types of criminal convictions that would prohibit a person from working or residing in a regulated child care program.
The city and state only checks for felonies in the last 5 years, not misdemeanors. So what does it take to be licensed?
They comply with all the regulations for kids. They have to keep it under 12, stay within ratios, for kids under 4. In order to get checked, they have to complete a background check, abuse and neglect checks. We do a sex offender check, and then they have to have first aid and CPR.
If Darger is found guilty, she may not be allowed to open another daycare again. Decisions at the state and city levels are made with the child's safety in mind.
If the provider was substantially out of compliance with the regulations, situations are reviewed on a case-by-case basis.
We look at everyone that comes in, and you know, if there's any question, we do discuss it amongst the peers and make decisions at that point.
In Sioux Falls, Sammy Bieland, Keloland News.
The Sioux Falls Health Department has revoked Darger's license pending the ongoing investigation. Background checks on daycare providers vary by state and city. Four states even require a check of fingerprints against state and federal records. South Dakota does not.
Oh, I think everybody out there is feeling pretty good about this weather. Is it going to last through your weekend?
Yes, it will, but not much longer, Angela. We had another day of above normal temperatures, even though today wasn't as warm as yesterday, thanks to that northwest breeze. 63 degrees right now, and it's warm all across the Keloland region. Pierce sits at 66. Well, not quite yesterday's near 80 degree temperatures, but not bad for the last week of winter. Here's a look at the temps around the region. The only place that's relatively cool is the northeastern temperature. South Dakota. There are a few clouds up there. Otherwise, here's what we're looking at for tomorrow. It is going to be a breezier, well, not a breezy day, except in the western part of South Dakota, but it will be cooler. 65 in Sioux Falls, 66 in Aberdeen, 75 in Pierce, 73 in Rapid City. Real nice with that sunny sky. Then it will be breezier on Sunday, but it's going to be even warmer than we saw today. In fact, temps close to what we saw yesterday. So, yes, Angela, it'll be warm this weekend, but next week not as warm. And I'll talk about that in just a few minutes.
The founder and CEO of Dollar Loan Center is putting construction on hold for several new stores planned for South Dakota. Chuck Brennan says he's holding off on the projects while a petition drive to cap interest rates at 36% on payday and short-term loans continues. Brennan says Dollar Loan Center makes the terms of the signature and title loans clear up front, and borrowers know the high interest rates they could be paying if they don't pay loans back. Brennan says there is a demand for the product. Otherwise, he wouldn't be in business. Hear more from Brennan coming up tonight on Keloland News at 10.
A Canton resident received the Distinguished Flying Cross for his efforts in the Vietnam War. More than 44 years later, he got the same award. Keloland's Leland Steva joins us now with the reasons why he got a new certificate today.
Angela, Dennis Lundstrom got the prestigious award for serving in the 173rd Aviation Company. He was a crew chief on a gunship, and his machine gun fire allowed lift aircrafts to safely enter and leave a very dangerous area. He received a medal and a certificate while he was overseas, but he noticed something wrong on the paper. This is the first Distinguished Flying Cross that Dennis Lundstrom got when he was just 21 years old. It's a military decoration that he's proud of, but his last name on the certificate was spelled wrong.
I told my CEO about it, and he says, well, let's wait. You can take care of it when you get back to the States. And when I got back to the States, I didn't even think about it.
He didn't do anything about it for years, but his oldest daughter thought he deserved the proper recognition for his heroic efforts. She contacted Senator John Thune, who today presented a new certificate to the veteran with the proper spelling. Most of Lundstrom's family was there to celebrate the accomplishment with him.
And we wanted to give them an opportunity as a family to recognize their father's, their grandfather's service, and for us to say thank you on behalf of a grateful nation.
Lundstrom served overseas for almost 2 years. He admits it was difficult getting back to normal once he returned to the United States, but he's made numerous friends that he's still in touch with.
I'm glad they got it right because, I'm proud of that medal. You know, and I'm sure this will get on Facebook, so my comrades on the Facebook will really get a kick out of this, so we'll have fun with it.
The veteran hadn't looked at the certificate in years. Now he's honored by his new certificate and his accomplishments, so it might find a new place in his home.
That's up to her, my wife. She's the decorator.
Lundstrom worked with the United States Postal Office for more than 30 years before retiring. He also served as the mayor of Canton for 5 years.
Thanks, Leland. Today, crews are hoping to start the process of trying to salvage a Black Hawk helicopter that crashed into the waters of Florida. Four Louisiana National Guard soldiers and seven Marines were killed when the aircraft crashed during a training mission in dense fog on Tuesday. Hauling the shattered helicopter core from about 25 feet of water could take up to 8 hours. But if weather conditions deteriorate, the recovery will be put on hold.
President Obama says there's still plenty of work to do to fix problems in the Veterans Affairs. He made his first visit to the VA hospital in Phoenix today. That's where treatment delays triggered a national examination last year into health care services for veterans. Obama is now promoting the need to restore trust and confidence in the VA system, and he points to mental health and suicide prevention as areas still in need of work.
Still to come, when that constant rundown feeling may be something more serious than just a lack of sleep.
But next, several homes in West Virginia are evacuated as a hillside gives way. A video of the landslide is coming up.
Clouds in the corners of Kelland. Most of us saw sun today. We'll see more sun tomorrow. A warm final weekend of winter to tell you about next.
The exclusive sponsor of Kelloland News at 5 is Vance Thompson Vision. Make this year the one where you see your best with the world's most advanced LASIK technology available.
Spring bonus savings are back at your local Northland Ford dealer. Come in today to get a great deal on a Fusion with an EPA estimated rating.